This is Bertalomescu, and you're watching the channel of the Medical Futurist. The scale for robotic design is incredibly broad, with the endpoints resembling R2-D2, as well as androids from the sci-fi series Westworld. The advancement of robotics comes with an array of mechanic creatures, ranging from metallic animal-shaped skeletons through humanoid robotic companions to highly human-like androids. Androids like Erika, Sophia, or Tara specifically aim to mimic humans in form and presentation too. They not only look recognizably human, but also possess several human traits and behaviors. Yet they freak us out. That feeling is the uncanny valley. Some believe it happens because your brain cannot cope with the cognitive dissonance. When you see a robotic robot, you categorize it as a robot. When you look at an android, your brain actually sees a human, but if some details don't fit the frames of being and acting like a human, it gets terrifying. So, where do healthcare robots stand on the uncanny valley graph? The robot dispenser robot, with its metallic arms and robotic movement pattern, obviously has a low human score. The robust dog robot and the streamlined robot courier, which make the in-hospital transport of medical devices, drugs, and sensitive supplies easier, wouldn't score much higher either. Therapeutic and social companion robots such as Sparrow, Pepper, Jibo, Buddy would be considered as a lot more likable. They are cute. And then we arrive to the valley.
Among the robot's autonomous actions, it can blink, roll its eyes, sneeze, shake its head, cough, move its tongue, and get tired of keeping its mouth open.
At the very moment, that's as human as we can make them. And it's at the deepest bottom of the uncanny valley. One thing is clear, if we can't create robots that are perfectly indistinguishable from humans, we might have to aim lower to avoid getting trapped in the uncanny valley. In other words, we might get more of this instead of this.
Hello, my name is Erika.